Hi, and welcome. Today we're going to go over how to create a ABA frequency graph using Excel. So there's basically three major steps. The first step is to take your sample raw data. The second step is to enter the data into the actual Excel program. And then the third step is actually creating the graph. Once you have this set up, most times you can just actually update the graphs by skipping step one, other than taking the raw data and then just adding it to step two and then modifying your graph in the future. But so today we're going to start with how to do it from scratch. So what you're looking at on your screen right now is a step one sample raw data, which is right here. This is a frequency of a daily count. A rate of reduction behaviors for our client, hypothetical client, RBT student. Down here are the dates, and then across are the behaviors to include cursing, elopement, and self-injurious behavior. In this sample raw data, we also have the initials of the staff members who actually completed the data for that day for our hypothetical RBT student. At the bottom, the tally marks for the week were totaled up for the weekly frequency, which is down here for each behavior. So now that you kind of understand our sample raw data, let me zoom out a little bit. And we're going to start with step number two, entering data into this program. So what you first want to do is make sure that you have your date aligned and then your behaviors going across. You could do it the other way around where you have your dates going across and your behaviors going down, but for my personal preference, and to me the easiest to read, is going to have your dates going vertically down and your behaviors going across horizontal. So here we have cursing and cursing, elopement, and SIB and SIB. We're going to start with the date 4/1/2020 and match it to each date that you have for your data. Now, because this is a continuous measurement, let's say that we didn't take data on April 4th. We're still going to include that in our Excel or in our graphing program. We just will end up having a blank for the actual frequency. Because it's continuous, we're not going to skip any days. And one way to do this, you can actually hit 4/1/2020. So let me delete this and kind of show you. And what you can do is actually just take this little square that's over here and pull it down, and it'll auto create the next sequential days. For the purpose of this tutorial, we're only going to go up to 4/7 since that's where our data shows. And then what we're going to do is we're going to actually enter the data, tally up each day's frequency and add it to here. There was four behaviors of cursing on April 1st. On elopement, we have 1, 2, 3 behaviors. On April 1st for SIB, we had 0. Then on April 2nd, we had 4 behaviors of cursing, 1 behavior of elopement, and 1 behavior of SIB. So we're literally just adding those numbers in, and we're going to do that for the remaining of the values. All right, so now that we've entered all our data per behavior per day, next step is to actually create a line graph. And we're going to use line graphs most often in behavior analysis. Remember, they're equal interval. We make sure we have our titles and et cetera. So to actually start creating a graph, we've already created one down here, but we'll show you how to modify the graph after we start to create one. So first, what you want to do is highlight the area of your data that you entered into the actual Excel program and highlight it. You want to make sure that you left click if you're using a PC and drag and highlight all the dates, titles, and all the data you want to use. Now, if you have multiple behaviors, let's say you have more than 3, so let's say you have 5 behaviors, 10 behaviors, you want to do this separately, kind of keeping your graphs a little simpler to read, either having one behavior, but try not to have no more than 3 behaviors on the graph. It becomes a little difficult to actually analyze and see the trends that are occurring for those behaviors. All right, so once you highlight the area that you want, so we included the date all the way to number 5 for SIB and the titles, You're going to go to the top left right here and hit insert. Depending on what program you have, if you have a more recent or newer version, you'll have a setup like this. If not, it'll just have like a drop down option of what you're looking for. So you want to come over here to the right where it says charts, and you're going to find the line chart. So here is a bar chart, a spatial chart. We also have a bar and line graph, bar graph, line graph. There we go. We also have a pie chart and a scatter plot. But for the purposes of this tutorial, we're going to use a line chart. So you're going to go ahead and click that arrow down, and you're going to select the one that represents yours. So if we go here, we have a smooth line. We have another smooth line. A smooth line, but however, if you see on the far left of this graph, it's actually in percentage, so that's not accurate because we're doing frequency and we need whole integers. And here we go, this one looks the most appropriate, so we're going to select that, and then we're going to start modifying this to include our chart title and everything else that we need. Here is the graph again. And what we want to do is make sure that we can see all our labels of the behavior. So all you got to do is extend that. So this represents all three behaviors. The blue line represents the behavior of cursing. The red line represents elopement. And the green line represents self-injurious behavior. Now we got to make sure that we have our dates are consecutive because this is a continuous measurement of frequency. We know our dates from our raw data started at 4-1. That's what we inputted in step 2. And it went all the way to 4-7. So we have 4-1, 4-2, 4-3, 4-4, 4-5, 4-6, and 7. There are no dates skipped. So this is an appropriate graph on the x-axis. Now with this, we're actually missing some labels. So let's go ahead and start with titling our behavior chart. And this was, we want to use the initials of our consumer. So this was the RBT student. And what this is actually demonstrating, and it is maladaptive. And we want to, in parentheses, possibly include the dates. Now, this will be up to your personal behavior analyst that you're working under the direction of as to what they actually need, but this is a good start. Next, we want to go ahead and label our x-axis. So remember, this is going to be the intervals of which we are recording the rate or frequency. So here we have from 4-1 to 4-2 to 4-3 and so on to 4-7. So this is actually a daily or dates. And next we need to enter our label for our y-axis. So we also want to make sure, because this is a frequency data collection, we want to make sure that each of these are equal intervals and that they're whole integers. So here we go from 0, 1, 2, etc. to up to 6. Now if this said 0, 1.5, 2, 2.5, we want to go ahead and shift that. And then if we have actually higher rates, we can actually modify this as well. So right to the left of your actual data points here, or what we're measuring, we want to type what type of measurement this is. And for the purposes of this, as we saw with our original raw data, we're using frequency. So we're just going to go ahead and label this as frequency. Now, if we were using percent correct or maybe some kind of interval type of recording, maybe time sampling, something like that, we wouldn't want to put percentage of intervals or what have you. All right, so that's it for creating a graph. Hope that explains everything, and thank you very much for your time.